What is the objective that Jesus wants to attain through the parable? What is the significance of the phrase, "For John came to you in the way of righteousness, and you did not believe him"? Why does Jesus say that the tax collectors and prostitutes are going into the kingdom of God ahead of you? All these questions and more answered during today's episode of Daily Reflections. The Gospel today presents a parable. Immediately, by means of a very simple question, Jesus tries to involve those who are listening and tries to communicate a message. He involves them in the story without at the first moment explaining the objective which Jesus has in mind. After they answer the question, Jesus applies the story to the listeners, and these become aware that they alone have condemned themselves. The story of the two sons. The story that Jesus narrates is a story of the daily life of a family. The persons who listen to Jesus understand what he is speaking about because they have lived the same thing many times in their own house. But as yet, many a times we do not understand what Jesus is thinking. Jesus tells a story in the form of a question. At the beginning, he says, "What is your opinion?" He does this to call the attention of the persons in order that they are attentive to the story which follows. And at the end, he asks, "Which of the two did the father's will?" Those who listen are parents and respond according to what has happened several times with their own sons. The chief priests and the elders will answer the first one. This is exactly the response that Jesus wanted to hear from them. And from there on, he takes the evidence to communicate his message. Actions and not words. The Gospel reminds us of something we often forget. Words can be meaningless. Promises are empty when not followed by action. The first son is arrogant, but his action shows his goodness. The second son sounds cooperative, but fails to keep his promise. Jesus asks us to think whether our words and actions are in agreement. It is easy to talk, to pronounce, and to make statements. It is more difficult to give time, effort, and attention. We can ask ourselves a question: whether do we profess our faith only in Sunday words, or do we also offer our help to those who are around us? Jesus values a few small acts more than many fine words. The kingdom of heaven is not promised to the charmers, but to those whose life would make no sense if God did not exist. The conclusion drawn by Jesus. In this parable which Jesus speaks of, the tax collectors and prostitutes, those most despised and rejected by society, are ahead of the self-righteous ones. They were the ones who were open to the word of God and to change. The conclusion of Jesus is evident and very hard. According to the opinion of the priests and the elders, the tax collectors and the prostitutes were sinners and unclean who did not do the will of the Father. According to the opinion of Jesus, the tax collectors and the prostitutes in fact said, "I do not want to," but ended up doing the will of the Father because they repent in listening to the preaching of John the Baptist. While the priest and the publicans, who officially always say, "Yes, sir, I will go," ended by not observing the will of the Father because they did not want to believe in John the Baptist. God continually invites us to fullness of life. We do not have to be downhearted by the awareness that we don't always accept the invitation, but we are encouraged by hearing the trust in us that is expressed in the call to serve others. Here are some points for our personal reflection. Can I apply this parable of Jesus to my daily life? Do I take time out to think about where I stand in relation to God? Am I ready to examine my actions and change myself? These points can be of great help to reflect on today's gospel. And if you like our reflection, do share the good news of our Lord. Have a good day, and may God bless you all. Amen.